Southwest Florida, you are looking live at a spectacle of magnificent proportion. We are coming to you from the Dunbar Easter Fest. You can also call it the after party. We are here in the Stars Complex Baseball Park, where we're waiting live entertainment that will be taking place on this stage over my shoulder. It has turned out to be a magnificent affair. We have hundreds of children over to my west in an Easter egg hunt. We have vendors all around the place. I gotta get me some food, Jerry. I run out of cash, so I'm gonna have to hit my godmom up for a few dollars. I'll pay her back. And we have right here a candidate for the Lee County School Board. And I'm thinking that this is her first television interview and radio. An icon in our community. The winner of the Lee Piss Live Person of the Year Award. And all types of accolades that she's received over the years. One Jerry Well. Jerry, welcome to Lee Piss Live.
Good afternoon, Lee. It's an honor to be in your presence.
You are always so clean. Presentation means everything to you.
Everything. Knowledge and presence.
Jerry, you, the one thing that I admire amongst the many things about you is you just don't quit. You don't give up.
Perseverance. Got the 6 P's for you, Lee.
Go ahead.
Pertination, pursued, precedes perfection. Persistent, perseverance. Pertinaciously pursued. Precedes perfection.
Okay.
That's the 6 P's. You got them?
Where'd you get that? I never heard that one.
Up here.
Mm-hmm.
That's mine.
You really feel that community is everything. The people are everything. I saw you looking at all those children over there and saw that big smile on your face. You're running for the Lee County School Board. But your love for children and their opportunities to have a fair shake in life has always been a part of your DNA?
Always a part of my DNA. Because for one thing, Lee, all of us have a purpose in this life. We were not born for anything. However, God chose me to advocate for children and old people.
You have put your hat in the race. What is your district?
This is four.
District four. Lee County School Board, the primary is coming up on August 23rd, and you are in it to win it.
In it to win it, if that is the will of God. I'm gonna give it my best. I'm gonna encourage people to vote. I'm gonna do everything within my power to make them know why I am the best candidate. And I'll tell them why, because I've got some C's. I gave you 6 P's, I'm gonna give you 3 C's in a little bit.
Go ahead and give me those 6 C's right now.
First of all, I am competent, I am very committed, and I am congenial. I know how to get along with others.
Ah!
And that is one thing our board is liking, because I observe too much friction at the school board meetings that I frequently go to, and that's, I've been doing it for years.
I see you there, giving them hell.
I've been there for years, and I'll still keep going there whether I win, lose, or draw, because perseverance. I have got to keep pressuring for the advocating for our children. It doesn't stop.
And for me, knowing you for over 30 years, if it's okay with you, I want to add another C there.
What's that?
No, two more C's.
Okay.
Character, and you care. Okay?
I very much care.
I'm saying that from my knowing her personally. She has great character, and she cares about the people. Those 3 C's fit you just as fine?
I'll put 2 more with my 3 and I have 5 C's.
Jerry,
I might find 2 more because you know the number 7 is complete. So I got to find me 2 more to make it complete.
Right now you're sitting out here amongst the people.
Yes.
In the community, smelling barbecue, hearing nice music, seeing the children running around. It's just a beautiful setting. Tell me, how did it feel, one, to ride in that parade and see all those people waving and calling your name, and two, how are you feeling out here right now, getting prepared for the fest in the community?
Well, Lee, first of all, my heart goes out to the children. First of all, I think about them. And I'm saying to myself, it is because of you that I'm in this parade saying, vote for me. And I'm saying to the people, if I could get all of you all out here to vote, like you all out here on the sidelines, we could really make change. Because I'm a catalyst. Catalyst for change. That's my other two C's. Catalyst for change. So now we got seven C's, Lee.
Hey, Jerry. The Dunbar community that we're in right now in the Stars Complex Park, is this a part of District 5?
Four, yes.
District 4?
Yes.
Do you feel that it has gotten its proper representation in District 4 on that school board?
No, it hasn't. Lee, for one thing, it seemingly, they don't care about whether we have competent representation. It's like a personality type race for them, as opposed to seeking someone who's competent, going there, who's really going to advocate, who has the knowledge, who knows how to advocate to make change, because that's what it's going to take to make any kind of change. We knew that from the civil rights movement.
Right.
Without us getting out there protesting and fighting, we're not going to get anything to change.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing goes for the school district. Right now, I've been so concerned about Franklin Park for years. Why is it taking us so long to get that school done when we can build schools all over the districts and get them done way ahead of time as opposed to Franklin Park? So I'll be right back before the school board at the next meeting saying, okay, when are we going to move? You all told me over
right.
6 months ago that's been approved, so when are we going to move the dirt?
What do you think is slowing the process up?
I'm not sure. I don't want to say that it's, I don't have a clue of why is it taking them so long.
But you do know that other places, they move faster.
And it's been proven. History, it proves itself. You know, I've seen schools built, and I'm happy for Lehigh, because Lehigh, the East, is another neglected area in our area. But when we go to other areas like Estero and Bonita, we can get schools out there quickly. But why not in the East Zone and here in District 4?
One of the things that stand out for you as well is that you're African American. Okay? If you are elected, there'll be, and Gwendolyn is elected, there will be two African Americans on that Lee County School Board. Do you think that would bring additional sensitivity and change to have more diverse thinking there?
Lee, I don't want them to look at my color for the diversity. I want them to look at me for competency.
Mm-hmm.
Gwen has shown that she's very competent, and she's been advocating her whole 4 years while she's there, fighting and fighting and fighting and fighting, sometimes with much adversity. So I don't want them to look at my color. I want them to look at what you said, my character, and my competency and my being able to get along with other people, to realize that it's not about me. It's not, the fight is not about me, it's about our children.
Right.
And how much better can we do for their education?
Well, I hear you on that. However, I want to make sure I say this. We know you got the credentials, we know you got the qualification, but also from my perspective, we know that you have a cultural understanding of all of the plight of the disenfranchised,
yes,
from your life. So that,
yes,
you bring additional knowledge to that board.
Also, Lee, I want to bring another fact to the table. Redistricting. We just completed the redistricting for this county. And would you believe that the school district, instead of drawing their own maps, they chose to, and our chairperson went to them seeking for their map, as opposed to drawing their own map. They had hired someone to draw their map. If they didn't have the intelligence to draw it, they had secured someone financially to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So why did they choose to seek out a map that is strictly gerrymandering? So that to me is that you represent gerrymandering.
Mm-hmm. Tell people what gerrymandering means.
Drawing the lines fairly. Like, for instance, taking Dunbar all the way over to North Fort Myers, all the way over in the North Gate. The lines are not supposed, it should be contiguous. They should be close to what people have in common. We don't have anything in common with North Fort Myers and in Cape Coral. No, keep us across the river where we should be.
I see. That poses an additional challenge for you in terms of District 4?
Sure.
That's
it does.
A huge challenge.
Sure it does, because first of all, we're going to have to try to make changes with the county commissioners, because seemingly the school board is going to follow whatever they do.
So that's going to be, that's still being legislated.
Yes.
And so, it's going to make it to the courts.
We'll be pursuing that when the Charter Review Board meets this coming year. They will review the charter for the county commissioners, and that's when they will begin to decide whether it's going to continue at large voting or single member districts.
I see. When people vote for Jerry Ware.
Why? Because I'm competent. First of all, I care. And as I said, I will advocate for change. I will make sure that I am able to get along with my counterparts, because that's going to be crucial.
Uh-huh.
We have got to get people on that board that can sit at the table and not fight like that and come out and realize what the greater cause is all about. Not my cause. The cause is the children. I sometimes think they forget what they're fighting for. Mm.
Well, you heard it right here in her first television and radio interview on Lee Pitts Live TV and radio show, as she's out here amongst the people running for District 4 for the Lee County School Board. The primaries are August 23rd. Jerry Ware is up for election, and she's in it to win it. Be sure to think about Jerry Ware when you go in that polling booth. Jerry, it's been a pleasure to have you on the show. I'm going to give you 30 seconds to look into that camera and make an appeal to the people.
To my voters, I am Jerry Ware, a true catalyst for change for all children, regardless of race, color, creed, or color. I am out here advocating for the betterment of our children and their educational processes, and to make sure that your dollars are spent protectively, correctively.
Run, Jerry, run.
We'll keep running.
As the saying goes on this show, Miami has the oranges, but Fort Myers got
the juice.
It's sticking, people. We'll be right back.
All right.
Stay right there, Jerry.
Thank you, love.